Colombo and Mike Awesome.
And by the way, real quick, whatever DDP is selling, we're not buying it unless it's Fat Bunny on Raw, but we won't go there.
Yeah, we won't go there.
I want to go there, but I won't go there.
You're big into the yoga, aren't you?
I do like yoga.
So you're a disciple, you're a follower of DDP?
Absolutely. I'm not a follower of DDP. I do like yoga.
We'll take that as a yes, and we move on. Listen to this crowd. This crowd enjoys the way the APA entertains them, and they also like the way they fight. They put the cards and the beer down long enough just to get out in the ring here and have a tussle.
That's what you gotta love about these guys. They care about three things. Not necessarily in this particular order. They like the suds, they like the cards, and they like to kick people's butt. It just depends what time of the day they do it.
An absolute bludgeoning in the corner on Chuck Palumbo by Farooq.
Well, you know, Chuck Palumbo's a young up-and-comer, very obviously physically gifted. But I think he's going to be taught a little bit of a lesson here on metal.
Here is a hook at the leg, two count only.
And I'm not saying that Chuck Palumbo and Mike Awesome cannot defeat the APA, but I'm saying from a physical standpoint, Palumbo and Awesome will be tougher after this match.
Well, they certainly will be, and I think Chuck Palumbo, every time he steps into the ring, it's another learning lesson. Chuck Palumbo has a tremendous background, a tremendous resume, a military background, college basketball. He's a great athlete all the way through. Really still cutting his teeth in the world of sports entertainment. And he's getting taken to the learning tree right here. Great rotation on the power slam, a near fall. And you see how very quickly Farooq snatches Palumbo. And a quick tag to Bradshaw. Double teaming is done. You know, we got to give props out to the new WCW Tag Team Champions. The Hardy Boys got a victory over Booker T and Test. A little help from a friend.
Well, certainly Booker T and Test would say that the Undertaker interfering was not the way the Hardy Boys should have won the tag team titles. However, if you remember how Booker T and Test won those tag team titles, then they can't be barking at all, if you will.
Ooh.
Oh, my goodness. Just kicking him like a...
What does JR say? Rented mule?
Scalded dog?
Something like that. Same.
Some afflicted animal.
Yeah, exactly. But, you know, the Hardy Boys, nonetheless, are the WCW Tag Team Champions. Booker T and Tess were not pleased at all. So now Booker T challenges The Undertaker. Of course, The Undertaker gladly accepts for no mercy. But now Tess must face Kane as well. I don't know if Booker T and Tess realize what they're getting into one-on-one.
Yeah, with Kane taking on Test and The Undertaker challenging Booker T, it's going to be a very interesting night at No Mercy. Those just two of the great matches that we're going to see next Sunday on pay-per-view. Palumbo, head of steam, into the corner, running right into the awaiting arms of Bradshaw. A little power display for you, Coach.
You know, the telegraph machine was invented like 50 years ago, Chuck.
50 years ago?
Maybe longer than that.
You're up on your history.
Yeah, exactly. Well, it wasn't exactly my best subject in school.
Do they have schools in McPherson, Kansas?
Easy!
They have one school. K through 12.
Well, that's where I went. A lot of people know where McPherson, Kansas is. Oh!
Sure they do. That's where all the UFOs go.
Enough.
Well, Chuck Palumbo has done his best to fight off Bradshaw, now making the tag finally. Mike Awesome. Welcome, Mike, to the match. By the way, it's been a great tag team encounter. Your partner's been doing a fine job.
Don't be scared to come in and join the fray.
Don't be scared to come get you some. Break off a little piece of something right here.
Say.
Uh-oh, Bradshaw missed the clothesline.
Oh,
head of steam. One of the best things that Mike Awesome does. He's so explosive.
Well, we talk about how great of an athlete. Wait a second.
Here is a cover. Farooq looking on.
You know, you talk about Mike Awesome and Chuck Palumbo. Physically, they are tremendously well put together. And they can certainly match up physically with the APA. But they need to be equipped. As we did, as Spike Dudley went through that table.
Yeah,
Dudley boys.
Spike Dudley was literally launched. Wait a minute now. Here is another cover. Spike Dudley was literally launched out of the ring through a table on SmackDown. Spike suffered a concussion and severely bruised ribs. And we understand that Spike is out indefinitely. The Dudleys certainly had a very destructive week. And if the APA got an opportunity to get their hands on the Dudley boys and another opportunity at the WWF Tag Team titles, I think that would be just fine. And
Gossip takes way too long when he gets to the top rope. Physically, he can get up there. Certainly, he can get the job done when he's up there and comes down, but you just can't wait that long when you got a Farouk waiting on you in the ring.
Farouk got himself in a bad spot in the ring. That's a rare mistake from a veteran. Palumbo makes him pay for it, and now the DDT. Tag is made. Here comes Chuck Palumbo. And can this team of Chuck Palumbo and Mike Gossip, despite the fact that they've never teamed up before, but they have very infrequently, giving up a tremendous amount of experience to the APA, can they pull off what would be a huge upset?
I think right now the alliance is trying to figure out what guys they can put together, what is actually going to work in order to make strides here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Oh, man, Bradshaw's in. Uh-oh.
Oh, my God.
Palumbo's starting to get a little hot.
Well, I think the ice is melting backstage. Oh, they want to get back there.
Yeah, they got to keep the suds nice and cold.
Nice and chilling.
You ever lost any card games to the APA?
No, I usually go in there knowing that I'm going to lose.
So you just hand
even
money.
If I win, I lose.
Well, there you see the spine buster from Farouk. And now he needs to make a tag. Bradshaw, fresh in the corner, ready to go. Referee Charles Robinson applying the count.
Well, both of these men need a tag in the worst way, KK.
Palumbo tags Ossoff in first. So wait a minute now. Bradshaw's tagged in far side. Here we go. Mike Ossoff takes the bottom of Bradshaw's boot. Ossoff set across.
Somebody must have buzzed Bradshaw on the fact that the ice is starting to melt. Because he's taking on both guys. He said, Farouk, if you don't want to help me, that's cool.
They have radar for that type of thing.
Exactly.
You just know. Off the neck breakers. Wait a minute. Now Palumbo is in. Farouk is in.
And now I think Farouk got buzzed as well.
It's breaking down in Tulsa.